So if you look at this material, you squish it onto your finger, right? It's thick and gooey, just like motor oil. And if you press on it, it's slippery, right? And it lubricates, just like normal oil. I like to do work that's going to help people. I enjoy helping dogs. I think it's important. But I'm in a biomedical engineering department. Our whole goal is to impact human health. If I didn't want to impact human health, I'd be in a different field. Going to humans is important. My friend Larry Bonassar is my partner in crime. He's an expert in biomechanics. He came to me and he said, Dave, can you make a polymer that looks and acts like lubricant? I said, Larry, what's lubricant?
Lubricant is a natural protein that coats the surfaces of our cartilage. Lubricant can decline in joints in several different ways. We know that after an injury, say an ACL tear, for example, that lubricant is lower in lower levels in the joints for up to a year. So it's acutely lower. You may lose 90% of the lubricant in your joint after something like an ACL tear for the first month, and it takes the balance of the year to get back to normal. And in that intervening year, whenever you're walking down the street or doing normal activities, friction in your joint is much higher. You are damaging the tissue, you're potentially damaging the cells, and as a result, the loss of lubricant that occurs after an injury starts the joint down this road of damage that continues over years and ultimately ends up in arthritis. Our interest collectively in making a synthetic lubricant came about somewhat serendipitously. I was at a seminar given by one of Professor Putnam's students, and I saw that he had made a molecule that looked a lot like lubricant.
And so he explained it to me, and he said, we want a material that will stick to the cartilage and act like lubricant, but be very simple to make. I said, oh, you mean like this? I took a paper that we had already written and just submitted and said, you want a material that looks like this? He said, yes. So we did some preliminary experiments, made some new materials, showed that they lubricated pretty well, wrote a grant to the National Institutes of Health. They funded it for 4 years. And through that collaboration, biomechanics from Larry Bonassar and polymer synthesis through my lab, we came up with this synthetic analog or mimetic of the natural material.
Testing the molecule, testing these lubricants on dogs is a natural thing to do. Canine arthritis is a huge problem.
And osteoarthritis in humans is the same as osteoarthritis in animals, right? It's not an animal model, these are canine patients. And so we went to dogs because we had some great collaborators, and we had a number of dogs that needed treatment.
And one easy way to tell whether a dog is in pain, particularly in its joints, is whether it's favoring one leg over the other. You can actually have them walk across force plates, and you can see whether they are putting an equal amount of force on both legs.
And we can look at these dogs over a period of 6 months. We inject them and see the effect of the material over these 6 months. We've treated 4 out of 5 total dogs, and all of them have responded to treatment. In a perfect world, we'd have a tablet or take a pill. But in the real world, you inject it directly into the knee. People do this already with hyaluronic acid injections. They do it with corticosteroid injections. And this is using the same principles, but with a new type of material. So the student who made this material, his name is Jason Sun. He's a polymer chemist. He's been working in the lab ever since he was a master's student.
There are elements of the tissue that are involved in bringing in water. There are elements that involve binding to the tissue. If you mix them up, the molecule doesn't work at all. You need to have them arranged in a way that the anchoring domain is sufficiently large, the lubricating domain is sufficiently large, but they need to be on the opposite ends of the molecule so it works correctly. And Jason's work was really instrumental in demonstrating how the architecture of this molecule needs to be exactly right for it to work.
Human clinical trials for these types of products take on the order of 3 to 5 years. So these are medical devices, these are not drugs, right? They work mechanically.
So our hope is that this molecule would be a very common treatment for arthritis. In terms of potential advantages over other existing products, it's easier to inject. We think it will be better tolerated than more viscous lubricants that are harder to inject into the joint. And based on the fact that it is a synthetic combination of compatible polymers, we think that we can scale up production to make this quite cost effective in a way that's better than many existing treatments.
So So in your opinion, what is the future hold for the synthetic lubricant?
In a perfect world, we'd have a company in Ithaca, New York that would develop this product and build the economy of upstate New York.